and then look for our third.txt. Huh. Okay, that didn't work.
Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. Let's find some hidden directories on a web server. My name's Ash, and I'm a cybersecurity enthusiast. On this video, we're gonna be going over a TryHackMe CTF challenge or room called Pickle Rick. For my notes, links, or timestamps, see the description. Otherwise, let's go. All right, so I have booted up TryHackMe here, and we've got the Pickle Rick room. And we can see here by our tags, we're looking for Directory Buster, which is a tool, Durbuster. Great, so let's open that up and let's select task one and let's go ahead and start our machine. While that's starting up, let's read our instructions. So this is a Rick and Morty themed challenge. So it requires us to exploit a web server to find three ingredients that will help Rick make his potion to transform himself back into a human from a pickle. So let's get into it. I'm gonna copy the IP. Okay, I've got my VM open. Let's first get on the VPN and sweet, we can ping 10.10.10.10 and we'll just go and try and ping our machine, which is live. Great. So we'll first do a Rust scan to see what ports are open. So we've got SSH running on 22 and port 80 being a web server, that's HTTP. And we can confirm that by our nmap results at the end there. So let's run this again with getting more information just for port 80 this time. And let's go and navigate to our IP running the web server on port 80. So we've got Rick in a classic Rick and Morty situation. I think this is one of the earlier images from the show. So let's quickly read it. We've got help Morty. I'm not gonna do a Rick. Listen, Morty. No, that's as good as we're gonna get. I need your help. I've turned myself into a pickle again, and this time I can't change back. I need you to burp, log on to my computer and find at least three secret ingredients to finish my pickle reverse potion. The only problem is I have no idea what the burp password was. Help me, Morty. All right, cool. So nothing too interesting here besides a little bit of lore. Sweet. So if we open up our view source, we have a note to self. Remember the username. Great. So that's one piece of the puzzle, I assume, that will come into play some area. So we've got a username. So next up, if we just go back to our further nmap scan results, we don't really get anything that we can't get. So since that the purpose of this is directory buses, we need to find some hidden directories. We could absolutely go ahead and use Durbuster. We could even use another tool like GoBuster in directory mode, but I'm gonna go ahead and use FerroxBuster just because that's what I've been using recently and that's what I like. So let's go ahead and find a words list that we can go ahead and run against this web server. So a part of the seclist discovery web content, there's a few that we can try. There's actually so many that we can try. I'm gonna go ahead and just use this one. It's really a case of just trying them out. And something else that I've been trying is using the dash X flag to specify maybe some extensions. So maybe we're looking for a PHP file. Okay, so straight away we see an interesting file with that extension.php. So I'm glad that I used that flag. Called login. So let's go ahead and select that. So we're looking for a username and we're looking for a password. Quick look at the view source and there's nothing too interesting here. We do see this assets directory and that also showed up in our scan. So unless there's anything interesting going into these images, there's nothing that really stands out straight away there. And I guess because we already have a username back from the index, we do have one bit of the information to log in, assuming this works. So we're really after a password. So another common file to always go ahead and check is our robots.txt. And in this case, this actually just has wobble of a dub dub, which if you're familiar with the show, which is a classic Rick catchphrase. So given that we're looking for a password and this wasn't following the format, there was no like disallow information here. It was just text. Pretty good chances that this is our password. And we're in. So this directs us to a portal.php. We've got a command panel with a command input and some sort of execute button, which gives us some result. Otherwise, clicking on anything, we've just got this denied.php, which says only the real Rick can view this page. Okay, so we can't go anywhere else. So we're left on this commands page. Now, interestingly, if we look at the view source, there is this string in some sort of base. So if we quickly go over to CyberChef and paste that in, it's saying from base 85, and we have the all zero group char or character cannot appear in the alphabet. If you know what this means, I would love some insight. So with that strange message out of the way, we're sort of left back here. So it's asking for commands. So let's just try and head and run some basics. Like, can we LS?
Okay, cool. So we can see some contents. Okay, so running Who Am I? We can definitely confirm that we are not a normal user. We are running as the web user, www-data. So if we print working our directory, we can even see that we're in the normal directory. So that's why when we list out our contents, we can see things like our robots.txt, which we had access to, and our other pages like portal, login, index, deny, etc. So the things that are kind of interesting that we haven't seen, and we've got this super secret pickle ingredient. Now, out of interest, can we just navigate that over the browser? All right, how cool is that? Okay, so I had a malfunction with computers, i.e. my mic was muted and I didn't realize. So I think this is what I'm up to. We found the first ingredient. We put said ingredient into TryHackMe. Then we looked at the clue.txt, which says look around the file system for the other ingredient, which we then listed out the home directory and we found the Rick user. And now we found the second ingredients file. Now we learnt that we can't use some commands like cat, so we can't read out. Using the dash LAH, we can see the permissions. Everyone, including my user that I'm logged into, has the ability to read, write, and execute this file. So let's just grab a copy of it to our current directory and then view it through the browser. So let's copy this file and make a copy of where we currently are. If we list out the current directory, that didn't quite work. So we might need to add a backslash because it's got spaces. Maybe we don't have permissions. All right, let's just take a step back. Okay, cool. So this backslash does actually work. We can see here that we can get some output. So this is recognizing it. So by rights, our working directory is here. Don't have the ability to write to it. Can I just make a directory? Let's do it this way. Let's copy this over into the temporary directory because everyone has rights there. All right, that did work. How do I see that? I got it to the temporary directory. Cool, but I can't see that. I don't know if I can do like a file traversal. So I don't think that this is gonna work because we don't have anywhere that we can write to. I don't think we're in this Ubuntu group. Yeah, we're in our own group. So I can't make a directory here. Let's ditch that. So we know that we have something here and we know that we can access it here. The issue is if we wanna cat out its contents, we've been blocked. So the other things that we can use is like seeing the top, using head, other things like using tail to see the bottom of the file. This is all being blocked. So this is where the power of bash comes in. So we can use a while loop, which if you're familiar with any programming, that'll sort of make a bit of sense. We're going to iterate through a file that we're going to pass through being the file that we're after. So while read line, we're going to say echo each line one at a time and then done. That's a part of bash, we're done. So that's how we can read a file. Hopefully. Now using our redirects, we are going to actually pass through a file. And the file that we want to read is second ingredients. Okay, cool. We finally got there. All right, so that's our second ingredient. We can paste that in, which now leads us to our final ingredient. So if we list that out again and with our hidden directories, there's nothing else here. So let's go ahead and look at our top directory and see if we can find it anywhere else. So some other important areas, we've looked at home. Maybe it's in Etsy, maybe something's mounted. We put something in the binary, in the temporary and look there. Let's see, we can't look in root. So let's see if we can do anything with elevated privileges by running sudo dash L. That'll tell us what we can run. And kind of shockingly, it says we can run absolutely anything, which means if I want to take a look at what is in root as if I was root, all I have to do is just go ahead and look at what's in root with sudo. And that works. So yeah, not very secure. All right, so here we have this third .txt and we're looking for the third ingredient. So let's write out our while loop again. So that's how we can read the contents. This time just making sure sudo is in front of it. And then all we want to do is go inside root and then look for our third .txt. Okay, that didn't work. Since we know how to read, why don't we just go ahead and copy that out and now put that into the temporary folder. So we have made a copy of it and now anyone can go ahead and read that. So we just use our while loop again, but this time go into the temporary and the third. All right, there we go. Oh, awesome.
All right, there was Pickle Rick. So we covered some hidden directory searching. We also covered some important bash scripting. And we used our noggin so we could get around some permissions and some tricky things to do with bash. So that was really good. So thank you so much for watching up until the end of the video. Up on the screen, you're going to see a recommendation to Pico CTF going over some web forensics and crypto challenges. So if you're interested in that, that's another great platform to go check out. So thanks, guys, and I will catch you in the next one.